¿cómo están aficionados? Nos encontramos con Matthew Hale y Laura Lavernia, quien es su esposa y arquitecta. Matthew Hale es experto en seguridad deportiva. Me acompaña mi compañera Romery Vázquez y quienes habla José Neira. A continuación, vamos a empezar con una ronda de preguntas. Matthew, ¿cuál fue el propósito de esta conferencia?
The purpose of the conference.
El propósito de la conferencia fue.
The purpose of the conference was basically to get journalists together and talk about different issues. A lot of the issues ended up being more about the future, the business future of sports and of sports media. Specifically, I was there to talk about stadiums, arenas, sports, and security, because my specialty is mostly security, because I've worked for about 15 years or so in various American facilities.
And de la CIP fue justo reunir a todos los periodistas que son especializados en este tipo de trabajo, ¿no?, en un foro con presentaciones que tienen que ver con el negocio, el deporte, presentaciones prácticas y algunas presentaciones como la de Blanco, que tomaron un aspecto más práctico en cuanto a seguridad de los estadios.
Sports infrastructure is complex. People look at it
la infraestructura del deporte es compleja.
In very different ways. Some people take people take an approach to a stadium, mm-hmm. like it's a bridge,
mucha gente,
or it's an airport.
Hay diferentes maneras de mirar un estadio. Se puede mirar como se puede diseñar como uno diseña un puente o como uno diseña un aeropuerto. Son diferentes escuelas de pensamiento en cuanto al diseño.
But it's not. It's
pero no lo es. Es su propia tipología, es su propio edificio.
It's a stage set, basically. It's a place where people congregate.
Donde la gente se congrega.
Not where they pass through, like in an airport.
No es un lugar de tránsito, no es un lugar donde la gente transita y pasa.
But it's a place where people come.
El aeropuerto es un lugar donde la gente va.
They stop.
Paran.
And they watch a game.
Y ven un partido.
That should be about them.
Que debe ser de ellos. Que debe ser sobre ellos.
So treating it as if it's some sort of prison or lockdown facility.
Y que tratarlo en cuanto a una perspectiva de diseño como si fuese una cárcel o una o hay medidas de seguridad quizás que sean un poco contraproducentes.
What do you think about your plan for security?
My plan for security for stadiums is different than the mainstream United States plan. The mainstream plans in Europe, Asia, South America, Central America, is a top-down approach where it basically is police, and more police. You start out getting into the parking lots through police. You get wanded, metal detection. Once you get inside, you find more police. Depending on your class, depending on your neighborhood, depending on your ethnicity, you are funneled into different places. There are usually barbed wire areas that are keeping you there. These are things that are probably going to happen at the World Cup and in the Olympics in Brazil in 1916. My approach is human-centered, which means that I actually believe in human beings. So a lot of the people at the SIP conference were talking about people are unreasonable. Spectators are unreasonable. They can't be dealt with. You have to have a line of police to stop them. You have to hit them. You have to knock them down. I don't believe that. In the experiences that I've had working in places like Wrigley Field and Soldier Field in Chicago, large facilities in Seattle and Portland, doing work in Los Angeles and New York, doing a lot of work, I've always used my own approach. And that approach has always been successful because it's given the respect back to the spectators. It hasn't been about authoritarian control and violence, because violence begets violence. If you treat people like animals, they may act like animals. So what I do is I do what I can to train staff to basically communicate. And that's what this is all about. That's what journalism is about. That's what all communications are about. It's about communicating with people on an individual basis, knowing their name, finding the leaders, the informal leaders that are inside there. Things that I saw at the game that I went to last night in Peru, where there was all of this security, but at the same time, the group was monitoring themselves. They were their own security. The easiest way to have a catastrophe, to have a riot, is to put a lot of police in a place and have them push people around. And I don't believe in that. And that's what the difference between my approach is and the mainstream approach, basically. Sorry, that's such a long answer.
And why you
want to
focus on the mainstream approach?
Well, for a long, right now I'm getting my doctorate or my PhD in stadium design and stadium security. And I guess I know pretty much everything about how the United States works, having, you know, worked in all parts of it. I'm not particularly interested in Europe because of the commercialization of the sports teams. So I've been looking mostly for a focus in either Central America. I've already sort of ruled out Mexico, so I've kind of wanted South America. Peru offers the perfect case study, especially Lima, because you have a growing mega city. You have multiple football clubs in the city. Each of them occupy different arenas of different sizes that have different fan bases. Lima is a complex city, and the areas around it, the provinces around it, as they come in to Lima, they create something even more complex. It's the perfect case study, really, if you think about it, because nobody pays attention to Lima, and that's unfortunate. People know that there's Machu Picchu. People know that there's ceviche. People know that there are tourist things, so they come for that. But nobody understands that there's a real functioning city. There is a humanity here that I have not seen in a lot of other places. Spatially, it's perfect. Geographically, it's perfect. It's only 5 hours from Miami where I live, so it's a place that, you know, it's good to go to. And it doesn't deal with a lot of the issues in Peru. It's the last thing I say with this. Issues in Peru can translate to issues in Brazil, in Argentina, in Ecuador, in Brazil, everywhere, in Honduras. But Peru is right under the radar. Nobody seems to know about it, and people should. And it's about time that people realize that Peru is a case study that should be heard and should be understood.
Thank you, Matthew and Laura. Bueno, chicos, esto es todo. No se olviden de visitarnos en nuestra página web, en Facebook, en Twitter. Ya, gracias, chicos. Cuídense.
Bye.